Good morning, students. This is Razia teaching 6th class science. Now in this class we are going to discuss 4th chapter, that is what do animals eat. Okay, here in 6th class first topic, that is first chapter, we have discussed about our food. Okay, we eat a wide variety of foods, isn't it? We are interested and we are fond of eating. We like eating. Okay, we like eating. In the same manner, how we like eating, we eat different varieties of food like biryani, chicken, and sweets like gulab jam, kalakand, cashew nut sweet, okay, rasgullas, okay, and these are all the sweets and these are all the foods what we eat. We fond of food. We are interested in eating a wide variety of foods. We have variety of foods. But what about the animals? What about the animals? We have a wide variety of foods to eat. Okay, so even animals are also fond of food. Okay. Even animals are also fond of food. They also eat a wide variety of foods. But only one thing we don't give them proper. Is it clear? Okay. So we should give them food, a variety of foods. Okay, they are also living beings. They cannot talk, they cannot say. We say that, Mom, I want gulab jam. Mom, please make me biryani. Please make for me biryani. We ask our father and mother. Are they able to ask? No, they are unable to ask. Why? Because they cannot talk. Is it clear? So, even these animals eat a wide variety of foods. Even all, how many animals we have? We have a wide variety of animals. A wide variety of animals means so many variety of animals we have. And each animal food habits are different from the other animal. Okay, for example, what do we see in our surroundings? What are the animals we are going to see in our surroundings? Especially cow, buffalo, isn't it? This cow, buffalo and dog, hen, these are the animals we see in our surroundings. Okay, so what does this cow eat? What does this buffalo eat? Have you ever seen a buffalo? What does they eat? Have you ever seen them when they are eating? Okay, they eat grass and small plants. They eat grass, cow, buffalo, deer. They eat small plants. They eat grass. Okay, and they eat dry grass also. They eat dry grass. Cow and buffalo, they eat dry grass. Why? Because especially in the summers, we don't have the green grass. In summer, we don't have enough water. All the land is dry. We cannot have the green grass. So the grass, what they are eating in those times, it's nothing but dry grass. Okay. So they eat dry grass. So the food habits of cow and buffalo is same. Okay, children. So the cow eats grass, dry green grass, dry grass, and plants. Even the buffalo eats green grass, dry grass, and plants. That means the food habits of cow and buffalo are same. Okay. Now let us discuss about dog. Dog is a pet animal. We all, most of our houses, we have dogs. Okay. This dog guards our house. It will not enter. It won't allow to enter the strangers. What is this? Who is a stranger? The person who is unknown is called a stranger. He does not allow the strangers to get in. Is it clear, children? So, most of our houses we have dogs. We tame them. Okay. So, have you ever seen a dog? Have you ever seen a dog? When you just throw a biscuit, just when you throw a biscuit, it just catches up. In the mid-air only it catches up. It does not allow to fall down. In the mid-air only it catches the biscuit and eats the biscuit. Okay. If you throw or if you throw a leaves or a twigs towards the dog, does the dog eat the leaves and twigs? Twigs means small, small branches. Okay, they are known as twigs. So, does it eat? Does the dog eat leaves and twigs? Does the dog eat leaves and twigs? No, the dog does not eat. We observe that the dog does not eat leaves and twigs. How do we know that it is not eatable? Why it is not eating? So, the particles which is eatable, only it can eat. The particles which cannot be eaten, they are unable to eat. Yes, sir. So, how does the dog able to find out whether it is eatable or not? By the dog sniffs. Sniffs means smell. The dog smells even though you are at long distance. Even though the food is at long distance, the dog smells. Okay. So, the dog smells and gets the food. If you throw the biscuit, just it catches in the mid-air. Just it catches in the mid-air and eats the biscuit. But when you throw the leaves and twigs, it is not, it just catching and okay, now I'm holding it. That's it. It is not eating. Why? Because it sniffs. It sniffs. Sniffs means take the smell. So it smells it, whether it is eatable or not. If it is eatable, if the particle is eatable, then it eats. If the particle is not eatable, it doesn't eat. Okay, children. So now these are all the animals. What I have said, we see in our surroundings. Let us see some more animals. Okay. So, how we are fond of food, even the animals, they are also fond of food. Only thing they cannot ask. Okay. They cannot ask with their mouth. So, we should grasp it and give the food for the animals. Is it clear, children? So, we should feed them. We can ask our mother and father. Father, I want biryani. Mother, I want biryani. Father, please bring me some sweets. Father, bring me some fruits. We ask them. But poor animals, they cannot ask. So, we should understand and give them the food. Is it clear to them? So, now, in this class, let us discuss found some animals, what they eat. Okay, so some food, some animals, they eat. The food habits of some animals is say, the food habits, as they are different animals, the food habits are also changed. The food habits are also changed. The food habits of cow and buffalo is different. The food habits of lion and tiger. The food habits of lion and tiger is different. So each animal is having different food habits. Okay, children. So each and every animal is having different food habits. Now let us see some food habits. Okay. Well, before they get the food, first of all, they should locate the food. How do they locate the food? By looking and seeing. And some animals by sniffing. Okay. So let us see some animals. Here I have written a camel bone for you, children. Okay now. So I have written serial number, animal or bird. What they eat or drink. What are they eating? How they find food. That is first and foremost thing. How do they find the food? When you just leave a buffalo, it just looks around. It just sees around. If there are any plants, then it eats. So, first and foremost thing is to locate the food. How the food is visible for them. Okay, they have eyes. They locate the food with their eyes. Is it clear? So, let us see. Let us start with a bird, that is sparrow. Here I have taken the animals. Some of the animals I have taken and some birds I have taken. First one, sparrow. What does the sparrow eat? The sparrow eats nuts and grains. Is it clear, children? Okay, so sparrow eats nuts. Sparrow eats nuts, worms, and grains. Okay, children. The sparrow eats nuts, worms, and grains. What do you mean by worms, children? Small, small insects. Worms are nothing but small, small insects. Next one. How they find the food, children? How they find the food? By looking and observing the surroundings. Okay, now. So, by looking and seeing. By looking and seeing. Okay, children. So, sparrow. What do they eat? What they eat or drink? They eat nuts, worms, and grains. Grains means rice particles, maize particles, which are in the smallest size. Okay. Then, how they find the food? They just locate the food. How do they locate the food? With the help of their eyes. By looking and seeing. Next one, dog. We tame the dogs. Okay, so dog is a pet animal. We tame them, we make it, we prepare it, or we make it to, we just tame the dogs. Dog is a pet animal. So wherever we go, we carry a dog. Even when we go for morning walk or evening walk, we carry a dog. Okay, so dog, have you ever seen a dog? Yes. When you just throw a biscuit to the dog, it just lifts its head up and picks it in the mid-air itself. It doesn't allow it to fall down. Okay, just picks up in the mid-air and eats. How does the dog eats? By looking or smelling? By smelling, sniffing. Okay, so what does the dog eat? The dog eats flesh and milk. Okay, bread, bun. So it eats bread. It eats bread. It eats flesh. When we eat chicken, the unwanted bones, whatever we cannot eat, the bones, okay na, and some chicken particles, we give it to the dog. So the dog eats bones, flesh. The dog eats bones, flesh and bread. How they find food? How does it locate the food? By sniffing. Sniffing means smelling. By sniffing. Next, vulture. Vulture. Where are the children? Vulture. It is in the flying in the sky. Okay, it is some miles away from the ground. Then as it is in the air and somewhere, how does it find the food? It is some miles away from the surface of the earth. Then how does it locate the food on the earth? Okay, they have some special senses, children. Okay, now, because of that senses, they locate the food. What does this vulture eat? What does this vulture eat? It eats dead animals. It eats dead animals. The vulture eats dead animals. The vulture eats dead animals. Okay, then how do they locate their food? By looking. By looking and seeing. By looking and seeing. Vulture. What does it eat? How does it find the food? When any animal is dead, we throw the dead animal. For example, cows, buffaloes are died. What do? We take to the roadside and we throw them there, far from the village. Far from our village. Okay, now. So, by looking at the dead animal which is placed on the roadside, the vulture, some miles, hundreds of miles, thousands of miles away from the surface of the earth. Even though it is away from the surface of the earth, from that distance, it observes the dead animal. It observes the dead animal and comes down to the earth and eats the dead animal. Is it clear? If that dead animal is thrown like that, if there are no vultures, can you imagine, children? If there are no vultures, can you imagine? All the dead animals are lying over on the roadside. And even when we are moving on the road, we cannot move. If we get a bad smell and it is decayed, we get bad smell. And as it is, the dead animal is decaying day by day. Some insects are also entered. Some insects is eating that body. And we get a bad smell. And from that, the microorganisms will prevail and we get diseases. Is it clear? So we get diseases if the dead animals are thrown like that. So all these dead animals are eaten away by the vulture. So vulture is eating the dead animal so that the dead animal is not spoiled. It does not decay. So our surrounding is, there is no microorganisms. Our surroundings is clean. So these vultures, they are eating the dead animals and making our surroundings clean. So we say that these vultures, they are a part of our life. Without these vultures, all the dead animals are fallen on the roads and we get diseases when they are decayed. So these vultures, they are cleaning the surroundings. So who do they clean? They are cleaning the surroundings. So the persons who are cleaning, we call them as scavengers. So that's why these vultures and eagles are called natural scavengers. Natural scavengers. Okay, children. So let us take the next one. Hen. What does a hen eat? Hen eats worms and grains. How does it find their food? By looking and seeing. Okay, now hen is a bird. It is almost in our surroundings. Even you may not have in your house, but we observe in our surroundings. Okay, hen is eating worms and grains. How is it locating its food? By looking and seeing. Next, cow. Cow gives us milk. Okay, so cow, what does it eat? It eats grass. It eats green grass. It eats green grass, dry grass, and plants. Okay, now. Then how? What does the cow eat? Green grass, dry grass, and plants. Cow eats green grass, dry grass, and plants. Next.
Even the eagle is also eating.
dead animals. How does it observe? Even though it is some few thousands of kilometers away from the earth, they can find the food which is located on the surface of the earth. Okay, that means the dead animals. What is their food? Their food is nothing but dead animals. They find the dead animals and come down and they eat or prey. Prey is nothing but eat. Okay, na? So they eat the dead animals. How do they find the food? By looking and seeing, they find the food. Okay, children? So, once again, what we have discussed, we just take a recap. What we have discussed today, what do animals eat? Okay, we have taken here some animals. That is, animals are birds. Animals or birds. I have taken some animals or birds. That is, what are the animals here I have taken? We have so many animals. All the animals I cannot write. Okay, so here I have taken only few animals. That is, sparrow, dog, vulture, hen, cow, cranes, and eagle. Okay, so what do they eat? Let us see what do they eat and how do they get their food. Sparrow. It is eating nuts, worms, grapes. How does it find the food? By looking and seeing. And the next one, second, here is a dog. Here, all the animals what I have taken is we can find in our surroundings. Next one is dog. Dog eats bread, flesh, bones, milk. Okay, like it drinks milk also. How does it drink the milk? It licks with its tongue. So, the dog eats bread, flesh, bones. How they find the food, whether it is eatable or not, how does they find the food? By sniffing, by smelling. Okay, so the next one is vulture. Vulture eats dead animals. It finds its food by looking and seeing. Hen. Hen is a bird. We eat chicken, no? Okay, that is hen. That is nothing but hen. So, there we sign that we eat chicken. And especially on some occasions. Chicken fry, chicken curry. Okay, now chicken is nothing but hen. Okay, so what does this hen eat? Hen eats worms, grains. And how does it find its food? By looking and seeing. Next, cow. Cow eats green grass, dry grass, plants. How does it find its food? By looking and seeing. So cow eats green grass, dry grass and plants. How does it get the food? By looking and seeing. Next one, cranes. Cranes. Cranes eat fish, frog. How does it get its food? By looking and seeing. Next one, eagle. The last one is eagle. Eagle and vulture, they are having same food habits. Eagle also eats dead animals. How does it find its food? By looking and seeing. This eagle and vultures. Eagle and vultures, they are eating dead animals. They are eating dead animals. As they are cleaning our surroundings, so that is why they are called as natural scavengers. these eagles and vultures called as natural scavengers because they eat the dead animals. They eat the dead animals and make our surroundings clean. Okay, children? So thank you, children. Thank you, one and all.